नेक्स्ट कम टू द सो दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ब्रीफली डिस्क्राइब एलोस्टेरिक एंजाइम्स. एलोस्टेरिक एंजाइम्स आर एंजाइम्स दैट चेंज देयर कॉन्फॉर्मेशनल एनसेम्बल अपॉन बाइंडिंग ऑफ एन एफेक्टर, दैट मीन्स एलोस्टेरिक मॉड्यूलेटर, विच रिजल्ट्स इन एन अपेरेंट चेंज इन बाइंडिंग एफिनिटी एट अ डिफरेंट लिगैंड बाइंडिंग साइट. प्रोमिनेंट एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एलोस्टेरिक एंजाइम्स इन मेटाबोलिक पाथवेज आर glycogen phosphorylase, phosphofructokinase, glutamine synthetase and aspartate transcarbamylase ATCH. So our next question is, briefly explain any one catabolic process. So catabolism is the set of metabolic pathways that breaks down molecules into smaller units that are either oxidized to release energy or used in other anabolic reactions. Catabolism is the breaking down aspect of metabolism, whereas anabolism is the building up aspect. So the third question is, what is triglyceride and mention structure of any triglyceride. So the triglycerides are lipid compounds composed of a glycerol esterified to three fatty acid chains of varying length and composition. These fatty acid chains can be saturated or unsaturated, and the chemical composition of each chain is different. So our next question is, what is cyclic photophosphorylation? Where and why does it take place? Cyclic photophosphorylation takes place in chloroplasts in the leaves. This process is called cyclic because when only PS1 or photosystem 1 is functional, the electron is circulated within the photosystem and photophosphorylation occurs due to the cyclic flow of electrons. So next, name the accessory pigments and their importance in the process of photosynthesis. Chlorophyll A is the core pigment that absorbs sunlight for light dependent photosynthesis. Accessory pigments such as chlorophyll B, carotenoids, xanthophylls and anthocyanins lend a hand to chlorophyll A molecules by absorbing a broader spectrum of light waves. So next is, what is PP pathway or pentose phosphate pathway? The pentose phosphate pathway, also called the phosphogluconate pathway and the hexose monophosphate shunt, is a metabolic pathway parallel to glycolysis. It generates NADPH and pentoses, that is 5-carbon sugars, as well as ribose 5-phosphate, a precursor for the synthesis of nucleotides. Briefly describe CAM pathway. CAM, short for crassulacean acid metabolism, is a method of carbon fixation evolved by some plants in dry circumstances. In most plants, the stomata, which are like tiny mouths that take in oxygen all along the surface of their leaves, open during the day to take in carbon dioxide and release oxygen. Next, mention the fate of pyruvic acid in the process of respiration. During aerobic respiration, pyruvic acid, which is formed during glycolysis, enters mitochondrial matrix. It undergoes oxidative decarboxylation to produce carbon dioxide and NADH. This reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme, complex pyruvate dehydrogenase. So, briefly describe the structure of ATP synthetase. ATP synthetase consists of two well-defined protein entities. The F1 sector, a soluble portion, is situated in the mitochondrial matrix, and the F0 sector bound to the inner mitochondrial membrane. F1 is composed of these three copies of E subunits. Okay. What is leg hemoglobin and how does it help in nitrogen fixation in leguminous plants? So, leg hemoglobin, also leg hemoglobin or legoglobin, is an oxygen carrying phytoglobin found in the nitrogen fixing root nodules of leguminous plants. Leg hemoglobin is shown to buffer the concentration of free oxygen in the cytoplasm of infected plant cells to ensure the proper function of root nodules. So the next is define anabolism. The synthesis of complex molecules in living organisms from simpler ones together with the storage of energy. Constructive metabolism. What are enzymes? An enzyme is a substance that acts as a catalyst in living organisms, regulating the rate at which chemical reactions proceed without itself being altered in the process. The biological processes that occur within all living organisms are chemical reactions, and most are regulated by enzymes. So the next is what did Hill demonstrate in his experiment on photosynthesis? He demonstrated that isolated chloroplasts would make oxygen but not fix carbon dioxide. This is evidence that the light and dark reactions occur at different sites within the cell. Hill's finding was that the origin of oxygen in photosynthesis is water, not carbon dioxide as previously believed. The next is, what is Blackman's principle of limiting factors? Blackman's law of limiting factors. F.F. Blackman in 1905 proposed the principle of limiting factor. According to this principle, when a process depends on number of factors, its rate is limited by the pace of the slowest factor. It determines the rate of photosynthesis. Next question, name at least 6 types of chlorophyll pigments. Carotene, an orange pigment. Xanthophyll, a yellow pigment. Phyophytin, a gray-brown pigment. Phyophytin B, a yellow-brown pigment. Chlorophyll A, a blue-green pigment. And chlorophyll B, a yellow-green pigment. The next question. Name the requirements for glycolysis. The first phase of glycolysis requires energy, while the second phase completes the conversion to pyruvate and produces ATP and NADH for the cell to use for energy. Overall, the process of glycolysis produces a net gain of 2 pyruvate molecules, 2 ATP molecules and 2 NADH molecules for the cell to use for energy for glycolysis. The next question is, write the structure for 3-PGA and pyruvic acid. 3-phosphoglyceric acid or 3-PG is the conjugate acid of glycerate 3-phosphate. The glycerate is a biochemically significant metabolic intermediate in both glycolysis and the Calvin cycle. This anion is often termed as PGA when referring to the Calvin cycle. In the Calvin cycle, 3-phosphoglycerate is the product of the spontaneous scission of an unstable 6-carbon intermediate formed upon carbon dioxide fixation. Thus, 2 equivalents of 3-phosphoglycerate are produced for each molecule of carbon dioxide that is fixed. So, these are the 2 questions which you have to answer in my comment box. Okay, the questions are, write the first reaction of alpha oxidation, and the next question is, name any 2 inhibitors of nitrogen fixation. Please answer this question in the comment box, otherwise I will be answered. The last and the final question is, what is the significance of biological nitrogen fixation? Biological nitrogen fixation is an extremely important process in the soil carried out by several groups of bacteria and actinomycetes, able to absorb the elemental nitrogen from the atmosphere and combine it into compounds that serve as nutrients from plants. So these are the bit questions from the plant metabolism. I hope you understand it better. So thank you.